It's time for the match game, Hollywood Squares Hour, with the stars of St. Elsewhere, Kim Miyori, Howie Mandel, Nancy Stafford, Hollywood Squares Hour, Gene Rayburn and John Bauman. Yeah! Welcome.
All right, all right, all right, all right.
It's good enough.
I must say to you, this audience, you've shown very good taste to applaud these thespians from St. Elsewhere. They're really a talented bunch here. In addition to acting, this one is a director. You've done two episodes, have you?
Two.
You're going to do more?
Hopefully.
Okay. Let him do more. He's okay. All right. Shall we have a go at it?
Let's have a go at it.
All right. Oh, you have a hairy chest.
Oh, my God.
He does?
It's a kind of a Velcro thing that I stick on there.
Velcro?
It's not Velcro, it's an application. It's a prosthesis of sorts. Uh-huh. It's Insta-hair.
You. Okay, Doc.
I'll cover it.
Right. Let's say hello to our two players here, Tita Volpe and Steve Serrano.
Hey there. Welcome.
Hi. We're going to get acquainted with these two, beginning with Tita. Tell us about you, please.
Well, I was born and raised in Hawaii.
Yes.
I currently reside in San Diego, where my husband was transferred via the United States Navy.
Yeah! Would you throw out the drunks? The sailors can stay. The drunks have to go. There. Yes.
I have a 5-year-old son named Ryan, and our newest addition is Leah Courtney, and she's 5 months old.
Uh-huh. And you're wearing, what is that, a flower? Cornflowers, are they?
Oh.
No, what are
they're
they?
They're baby carnations.
Oh, baby carnations.
Yes.
They're very, are they fragrant?
Well, to tell you the truth, they're artificial.
Artificial.
Yes.
Well, Tita, good luck to you. Steve,
you.
Let's hear about you, please.
Well, I'm 28 years old. And
you don't have to tell us everything, Steve.
Oh, okay. Just the facts, right?
Right.
Okay, I just recently, last August, quit my job to go to the University of Arizona at Tucson. I'm a freshman studying computer science.
Uh-huh.
And I enjoy backpacking and camping and playing the guitar.
Really?
That's
what kind
I
of songs you sing on your guitar?
It's an acoustic guitar, so those are the kind of things I play.
Oh,
nothing
you
like
play.
The heavy metal like they do.
Isn't it wonderful what Vidal Sassoon can do?
Hey, he stole that off Begley's chest.
Okay, good luck to you here in the match game. You'll have 3 rounds to match as many of the stars as you can. And the winner will go on to challenge a returning champion in Hollywood Squares, so we'll have a chance to win up to $30,000. Tita, you won the toss, so you'll go first, if you please.
I'll take B.
All right.
Please.
You've got it. Joyce said, Harry Hector must be the hairiest man in the world. Would you get your act together?
Didn't get all
He's
the
hairiest man in the world. He even has to shave his blanks. Splendid. All right, Tita. Joy said, Harry Hector must be the hairiest man in the world. He even has to shave his blanks.
Well, with power of suggestion, I would say his chest.
His chest?
Oh, you mentioned it with Ed.
Yeah, a really hairy man. Well, I suppose chest is one possibility, but we were thinking of more ludicrous parts of the body that you might have to shave.
I was, too. I went against the grain here. I went for ears.
Ears? That's one thing. Sit down. Leave him alone.
Give us
Barabbas.
What are they going to scream next?
Wow. Hello, Kim.
Hello. Grown now. Okay. Eyebrows.
Eyebrows. They grew real long.
Tough crowd.
Yeah, they are.
I think Ed had a wonderful answer.
Ears.
His ears. You're welcome.
You'll let us know when we come to a good one, won't you?
Yeah.
Thanks. Okay, John, he even has to shave his blinks.
Well, if you were watching the show yesterday, you found out that my father was a dentist. So I, naturally enough, said, I think a very good answer. Teeth!
Yeah. Very good.
Drunks back in. All right. Thank you, drunks.
I'm a very sensitive man. Please don't boo. Eyebrows.
Okay. Oh, I think that's good.
You gonna take a walk?
You're an ugly bunch.
Yeah. Good answer, Eric.
All right. All right. Shall we go for a swim?
No.
All right. Hello, Howie. How are you today?
Oh, I'm pretty good.
Love your outfit. Listen, you got to show the people your shoes.
My shoes?
Yes.
Howie.
Howie. Look at this. How about that? Does that hurt, Howie?
Well, it kind of feels nice.
It does? All right, we'll do the whole show this way. Go ahead. Show us your answer.
I said, because I've had to do it, teeth.
Teeth is very good. Yeah. Now, Howie, if you'll excuse me, Eric, would you hold this, please?
Sure.
Thank you very much. All right, Tita, you didn't score there. Let's see if Steve scores here. All right. Harry said.
They're Harry.
It's not the same here. Harry or Harry?
Harry. Harry said, they told me my blind date had that outdoors look. And they were right. Her face looked like it was left outside and a blank hit it. Sorry. I guess we can put this back where we found it.
Howie's kind of got
there
a leg
go.
Up on the proceedings,
right.
Huh?
You were just pulling my leg.
Yeah, we're
just...
Gene,
oh,
read,
yes,
read
of course.
Again, read
yeah.
again.
Harry said they told me my blind date had that outdoors look, and they were right. Her face looked like it was left outside, and a blank hit it. All right.
He's shaking his head.
Here we go, Steve. They told me my blind date had that outdoors look, and they were right. Her face looked like it was left outside, and a blank hit it.
A bear. Hey, it's outdoors.
No, what they're doing is the audience is giving you equal time. They booed her, so they felt they had to boo you, too. But I must say, it is a rotten answer. Hello, Ed.
I said truck hit it.
Truck is good. You got the idea now.
I also said truck.
So two trucks.
Two trucks.
Yeah. Did you think of that?
I was thinking more nature, natural phenomenons like lightning bolts.
Lightning bolt is good.
Thanks.
Yeah. So we have three good answers from the people upstairs. And we come to you, Joe.
Well, the same thing struck me as struck Nancy. A lightning bolt.
Right. So we have two of those and two trucks so far, Eric.
And the best answer, tornado.
Tornado, another good one.
Oh, yeah.
Gosh, there are a lot of good answers over here, Steve. You're so far, you're the one who gave a rotten one there. What do you say, Howie?
We think along the same lines. I said a car, but it's driven by a bear.
Ah.
That's right.
Very good. Can we get
That's
a half a match A&R. For that? A car driven by a bear. Zip to zip is a score here. That's the end of round one. Round two right after this. Here we go with a second round. Okay. Now we go to the second round. And since the score is tied here in this ferocious battle between the two of you, and she went first last time, Steve, turnabout is fair play. You go first this time.
Well, I'll have B this time.
All right. Let's see what B says. In the X-ray room, one doctor said to the other, This man has no heart. He must be a blank.
Oh,
Isn't this a wonderful question?
Good one.
Especially for you people from St. Elsewhere. All right. Now, Steve, in the X-ray room, one doctor said to the other, "This man has no heart. He must be a blank."
A corpse.
A corpse.
A dead man.
Oh, wait a minute. Hold it. Steve didn't want to break his record. So, I mean, that's two, Steve.
Throw the trunks off
that's
the panel.
Two. All right, Ed.
Most of the corpses we get in pathology have hearts.
That's right.
I must say that for starters. I don't want to disillusion him.
That's right.
But I'm thinking also of my answer this time of year, and I would say tax collector.
Tax collector is a good response. Are there about three or four really good responses here, Kim?
I didn't want to offend anybody, so I said a tin man.
A tin man. And the Wizard of Oz, remember the Tin Man supposedly didn't have a heart in the beginning of the play, but he did end up with one at the end, didn't he?
Yes.
Now, what do you offer?
This shows you my narrow frame of reference here. I mean, I have tunnel vision, and this is no reflection on my wonderful, wonderful Lori Perlman, but an agent.
You're right! Now, that's a great show business answer, because most performers are not too fond of their agents. And most of them do indeed believe that they don't have hearts. Or they have a dollar sign for a heart. What did you say, Joe?
Come on, you guys! This is an election year! A politician! I cannot promise you a better answer.
All right, Eric.
It's not the greatest answer. Vampire.
Vampire.
No, wait a minute. You have to consider. I thought that's what Steve would say. That's the only...
Careful, he'll do it to you. He's got a big overbite. Oh, hello there.
Hi, I couldn't think of anything, honestly. I really couldn't think. Nothing.
Now, wait a minute.
And we're running out of time.
Did you even think of agent?
No, so naturally the first thing that came to my head was a stinky fish. A dead stinky fish.
Oh, a dead stinky fish. Oh, of course, that makes sense.
Run over by a bear in a car.
Who's a politician?
Right. T, you ready? All right. Muggsy said, when I got married... Muggsy. When I got married, I was so poor, instead of a wedding ring, I put a blank on my bride's finger. So poor. Here we go. Ready or not? Tita. Muggsy said, when I got married, I was so poor, instead of a wedding ring, I put a blank on my bride's finger.
A piece of string?
A piece of string.
String. I'm keeping it close, keeping the score close.
Yeah, she didn't want to get ahead of Steve, so... That's why she said string. Oh, boy, we're going to have a dumb-off here, I think. All right, Ed.
Don't take it personally.
I went for the traditional poor nuptial band, the cigar band.
Well, certainly. Right.
Traditional.
Yeah, that's a wonderful answer.
A two-carat cigar band.
Two-carat cigar band for Nancy. Show us your cigar band, John.
I didn't really think this was going to match, but it's pretty funny. A bathtub ring.
Bathtub ring.
How about a rubber band?
A rubber band.
Yeah.
I had string, too.
Hello, Howie.
I was going to say stinky fish, but I went with bathtub ring.
Bathtub ring. Yeah. No string there, Tita. So that's the end of round two. And we still have this tight pitchers deal going. Okay, third and final round right after this. Here's the third and final round. Now, let's see. He went first last time. And since the score is still tied, Tita, you go first this time.
I'll take B.
B?
Please.
Why is it everybody starts with B? All right. Hey, did you hear what happened to the world's worst vaudeville act?
What?
Oh.
How big?
You. I am glad you want to know.
How worse were they? Oh.
The world's worst vaudeville act, the human fly, was the name of it. As the fly was climbing up the wall, the audience blanked him.
Hey, they could remake that with my.
You are beyond help. That's excellent. Yeah, very good.
Be a good part.
Ready, Ed and Kim?
Yeah.
Tita, did you hear what happened to the world's worst vaudeville act, the human fly? As the fly was climbing up the wall, the audience blanked him.
Swatted him?
How's that sound? Now, that brings a smile to Tita's face to hear that positive reaction from the audience. Ed?
Come sweep the board, babe. Come sweep.
All right.
Swatted.
That's one, two.
Atta girl, Tita.
Wow. Three. Go, John.
Swatted.
Four. Hey, Eric. Swatted. For you, it's easy.
Yes.
Easy. Yeah. Now, the best you could do, Steve, is achieve a tie. And you can do that by matching all the stars, as she just did. So right. Don't think it's impossible. In the Garden of Eden, Eve said, she says, my man Adam. It's the way Eve talked. She said, my man Adam is the first preppy. He even has a tiny alligator on his blank.
Swatted.
Ready, Nancy?
Oh, yeah.
All right, Steve. In the Garden of Eden, Eve said, my man Adam is the first preppy. He even has a tiny alligator on his blank.
His fig leaf.
Fig leaf. Okay. Well, I think they finally both got the hang of it there. There it is. Fig leaf. One. What?
His chest.
His chest. All right, so Tita wins the game. What do the rest of you have down here?
Begley.
Come on. Hey, Steve. Great to meet you.
Thanks a lot, Gene.
Could have sent a lot of stuff to you from the Match Game.
It's been real, everybody.
Steve Serrano. How do you feel?
Pretty good.
Good. All right, here comes the rest of our set for the Hollywood Squares part of it. John and I will trade places.
See Gibson's variable speed Washmaster automatic washer, designed to save time and energy for a smashing automatic dryer with vacuum dryer system for energy efficient drying power furnished by Gibson. And now it's time for more of the Match Game Hollywood Squares Hour with more of the stars as seen elsewhere. Norman Lloyd. Ellen Free. The star of the Hollywood Squares, John Bowman.
Okay, we're going to be back to play Hollywood Squares in just a couple of minutes. Be back with us.
And now, John Bowman and the Hollywood Squares.
How am I doing? Congratulations, Tita. You broke the ice and made it through the Match Game. Very well done. We also have three brand new celebrities. We have Norman Lloyd.
How do you do?
Ellen Bree. And Terence Knox. All of them, of course,
I'll spit water.
From the hit show St. Elsewhere here on NBC. And Norman, your character on the show has a very interesting situation facing him, a very severe illness. Tell us.
Yes, John. I play Dr. Auschland on our show, and we're all very proud of our show. And on the show, much of his drama stems from the fact that he has this illness. And I couldn't help thinking, by way of contrast, of your delightful show, Match Game, Hollywood Squares, where we've all had such great fun. And it put me in mind of the words of that superb actor, Edmund Gwenn, who on his deathbed said, "Dying is tough, but not as tough as playing comedy."
Well, it's a pleasure to have you here, and you're playing comedy very, very well.
Thank you, John.
And certainly not dying. Tito Volpe.
Thank you.
Match Game is tough, but Hollywood Squares is tougher. Here we go.
That's true or not. They're probably about equally tough. What do you think, Christine Ledinsky? You're back for your second day. $675. You probably think Match Game was tough, Hollywood Squares was tough, and Supermatch was toughest. Tell us a little bit about your life to date, my dear, just as a reminder.
Well, I was born in Canada. I live in Covina. I lost my voice. I love horseback riding in the outdoors.
Okay. We're going to play Hollywood Squares until you hear the time's up, Belle. Mercy. Whoever is ahead, you can see, is anyone there a throat specialist? Christine? We're going to play until you hear the time's up, Belle, and whoever is ahead goes on to play Supermatch. It's worth up to $30,000. First game's worth $100, $25 for every square. Christine, pick a star and let's go.
Kim, please.
Kim Miyori.
John Bauman.
According to Mademoiselle Magazine, will wire hangers really ruin your lace blouses? Or was Joan Crawford just being picky?
Well, I know all my lace blouses are on wire hangers. So I would say it would be all right.
Agree or disagree, Christine?
I'll disagree.
Wire hangers will really ruin your lace blouses. You're right to disagree.
Very well done. No voice, but a lot of brains. You get the first square.
Okay, Tita Volpe, she's off to a good start. You are playing O. Pick a star.
Jean, please.
Jean Rayburn.
Okay, Tita.
Will multivitamins help your fern?
What? Where is my fern?
Or will they make your fern wilt?
I don't think so. I had a neighbor who had rose bushes, beautiful ones, and she used to put antibiotics in the root system, so I would say multivitamins can't possibly hurt my fern. Has anyone seen my fern? It was a walking fern, a beautiful specimen.
So they will help your fern?
Yes, and your fern fronds will be prettier than ever.
Agree or disagree, Tita?
I'll agree.
Multivitamins will help your fern.
All right, you agree.
Okay.
You're in the square.
As we know, a healthy fern is a happy fern. Christine, your move.
Ed, please.
Ed Begley, Jr. Ehrlich, you're a pig.
I'll say. On and off screen.
That's the character he plays on St. Elsewhere, and people are always saying, Ehrlich, you're a pig. But this time you're a real pig, Ed. Were you born with a curly tail, or did it start curling when you reached puberty?
Oh, boy. Trying to think from my personal experience with other pigs I've gone out with. Let me think. No, it's very straight on birth and it curls later, yes. I'm not sure if it's puberty, but it does curl later.
Don't be sure of anything you can't pronounce, Ed.
This is true.
Ed says that the tail started curling when the pig reaches puberty. Agree or disagree, Christine?
I agree.
The pig's tail is born curly. No, that's a break for your opponent. You should have disagreed with Ed. Your opponent gets that square and has a bit of an advantage in this game. We're going to find out what happens after these messages. Return with us.
Stay tuned for more of the Match Game Hollywood Squares Hour. Now back to John Bauman and the Hollywood Squares.
All right, Hawaii 50. Covina, by way of Canada, 25. It is your move, Tita. You are playing O.
Norman, to win, please.
This could give you the lead, a $100 game. Norman Lloyd, you have a 1984 penny in your pocket. Does it contain more copper, more zinc, or more nickel?
More zinc.
For the game, agree or disagree, Tita?
I agree.
It contains more zinc. You are right to agree.
Very well done. You get the spread. You win the game. I don't know whether you knew that or it was a guess, but could have fooled me. Today's pennies are, in fact, 97.5% zinc.
So the old copper penny is no more. We will clear the board, move on to the next game. You have a lead, but we got plenty of time. Christine, start us off.
Jean, please.
Jean Rayburn.
All right.
According to the L.A. Police Department, Jean, is the average mugger out of work, or does he have another job on the side?
I was only the muggy once in my life, and I never want to have that experience again. I would say the average mugger is out of work and is looking to pick up some cash.
Agree or disagree, Christine?
I'll disagree.
The average mugger is out of work. No, you should have agreed with Gene in that case, and your opponent gets off to a good start in this game. So you got 1-0. Go for another, Tita.
I'll take Kim.
Kim. Who sleeps longer each night, Kim? An average member of Weight Watchers or an average elephant?
How should I know? I'm neither. okay. An average Weight Watcher?
Or an average elephant. One of them sleeps longer.
Okay, let's see. Weight Watcher. I'll guess. An elephant.
Says the average elephant sleeps longer. Agree or disagree, Tita?
I'll agree.
No. The average Weight Watcher sleeps longer. Okay, so that kind of evens things up.
We talked about how once every 4 years an elephant's up all night. So you should have known that.
An elephant makes love once every 4 years. If you didn't watch yesterday's show. The average elephant sleeps 3 hours a night. Only 3 hours a night. Christine,
that's
your
what
move.
He says. You can't all believe that damn thing.
Norman, please.
Norman Lloyd for an X. Norman, in 1958, according to the Gallup poll, who was the most admired woman in America? Was it Marilyn Monroe or Eleanor Roosevelt?
It was Marilyn Monroe.
Was it, Christine?
I'll agree.
It was Eleanor Roosevelt. No. You should have disagreed. That's a tough
question. I
want
to say in passing that my vote would have been for Eleanor Roosevelt if you asked me whom I admired.
Thank you, Norman. Your move, Tita. Pick a
Ed
star
to win,
for a no.
Please.
Ed Begley could win you another game and give you a big lead. Ed Begley Jr.
Yes.
Who was seen first at U.S. airports, the Boeing 707 or the Hare Krishnas?
The 707 was early 60s, I believe, and I don't think the Hare Krishnas got there till late 60s, early 70s. I will say the Boeing 707.
Says the Boeing 707 was seen first. Agree or disagree, Tita, for another game?
I'll agree.
The Boeing 707 was seen first. Very well done. You're right to agree. You get the square and you win another game. Congratulations. And Ed was very, very close on his statistics, too. The Boeing 707, 1958, you said the early 60s, very, very close. Hare Krishnas came about 10 years later. Okay.
I bought their book.
We're going to clear the board and move on to the next game. You're going to start it out, Christine. Your move with an X.
Kim, please.
Kim Miyori. Do girls have an Adam's apple, Kim? Or is that something only boys have?
Well, of course, this is a trick question, right? Because we're going to assume that women do, but it's only smaller. Well, no, I don't think they do have an Adam's apple.
Agree or disagree, Christine?
I'll agree.
Girls have an Adam's apple. Absolutely. They're just not as big. The reasoning that Kim rejected was
different.
Completely right. And your opponent gets a good start in this game, gets the first square. We're going to find out what happens right after this. Don't miss it. 475 to 50, but stranger things have happened than coming back from this kind of deficit. If I shut up soon enough, we'll continue this game, and you can have your chance to catch up. Mm-hmm. Tita, it's your move, though.
Nancy, please.
Goodie.
Okay.
Goodie.
Nancy Stafford, you've got a splitting headache, so you head for your bottle of aspirin. When you open it up, it smells like vinegar. Should you throw it out, or is that normal?
Throw it out.
Agree or disagree, Tita?
I disagree.
You should throw that bottle of aspirin out. If it smells like vinegar, get rid of it. No, you should have agreed with Nancy.
So
your opponent gets that square, and this game evens up, and Christine is applauding. Christine, pick a star for an X.
Howie, please.
Howie. I'm from Canada, too, you know.
Yes.
Arthur?
Where are you from?
Ottawa, Ontario.
I'm from Toronto.
Arthur?
Are you from Toronto?
Howie, can an ostrich really bury his head in the sand? Or would he suffocate if he did that?
No, an ostrich can really bury his head in the sand. He doesn't suffocate. He doesn't breathe. An ostrich holds its breath while its head is in the sand. If he was trying to breathe with his head in the sand, he would suffocate. But he's not breathing while his head's in the sand. He's just scared.
Thank you, Doctor. Agree or disagree, Christine? He says he can. The ostrich can bury his head in the sand.
I'll agree.
Well, you could have fooled me. An ostrich would suffocate if he tried to bury his head in the sand. If he actually... Another myth has been exploded. Another myth exploded on the Hollywood Squares. Your opponent gets that square. And Tita, you have an advantage in this game as well. Make your move.
Norman to win, please.
All right. This could really put it away if you get this one right. Norman Lloyd, what are more people in the U.S. collecting today? Postage stamps or Social Security?
Good, Ed.
That's a very good question. And I would say postage stamps.
What would you say, Tita?
I would agree with him.
More people in the U.S. today are collecting Social Security. You should have disagreed with Norman. Your opponent gets that square and blocks you there instead. 36 million people collecting Social Security, 22 million people collecting stamps. So quite a few for each. Christine, your move.
Ellen, please.
Oh. Ellen Bree.
Yes.
We all know the official Boy Scout motto is be prepared. What is the official Girl Scout motto? Is it be prepared or always be a lady?
Always be a lady. You know, I was a Girl Scout, and I don't remember, but I think I would have remembered if it was always be a lady, and I don't think it was. I think it's be prepared.
Agree or disagree, Christine?
I'll disagree.
The official Girl Scout motto is be prepared. No, the audience was right. You should have agreed with Ellen, who tossed her cookies this way, and...
Cookie
your
bits.
Opponent gets that square. Tita, your move.
Eric to win, please.
All right. Another shot at a great big lead. Eric Laneuville, you have just been introduced to Nancy Reagan. What should you call her? Madam First Lady or Mrs. Reagan?
Or Mrs. T.
Madam First Lady or Mrs. Reagan?
Mrs. Reagan.
Yeah, one of those you should
Mrs.
call.
Mrs. Reagan.
He says you should call her Mrs.
Reagan.
Tita, for the game and a great big lead, agree or disagree?
I agree.
You should call her Mrs. Reagan. You're right to agree. You get the square. You win the game. And you got a lead of $850 to $100. Okay, there is still time. Sweep the X's and O's off the board. We're going to start a $400 game. You are going to start it, Christine. You may be in critical care, but we still have some time. Pick a star.
Kim, please.
Kim Miyori.
Please let me get one right.
I feel so bad. Her voice and she's so far behind. According to the American Dental Association, Kim, will eating a cheese pizza be good for your teeth? Or is it just about the worst thing you could ever do?
A cheese pizza. Gosh, what's in a cheese pizza that would be the worst thing for your teeth? Is it, you're saying it's either good for you or it's the worst thing.
Right.
Right?
That's right.
Okay. I think anything that you eat is... can deteriorate your teeth if you don't take care of it. So I would say it was bad for you.
She says it's the worst thing you could do for your teeth. Agree or disagree? One of the worst.
I'll agree.
Eating a cheese pizza, believe it or not, it's not your day because eating a cheese pizza is good for your teeth, which...
I don't believe it.
It's bad for your silk flowers.
According to the American Dental Association. Okay, your opponent gets that square. Tita Volpe.
What?
Ah, call the American Dental Association. Your move, Tita.
Terence, please.
Into the fray, Terence Knox. For dinner, you're eating a capon.
A what, ma'am?
A capon.
What's that?
A capon, which is a neutered rooster.
So
Sort of like
oh, hey, let's not have nothing to do with any of that.
Terence.
They said I couldn't talk about anything like that on the show.
Does the neutering take place early in the rooster's life? Or is it a surprise? Right before he goes to market.
Thank
Happy
Terence.
Neuter to you. Happy neuter.
I know it's a surprise, you know, because no rooster in his right mind would walk in and do that, you know.
Right, it's a surprise in either case, but does it happen early in his life or right before he goes to
early in his life, or he'd be running around with the hens before, you know, they had a chance to get him to market. And he'd be all worn out and he wouldn't weigh enough, because when they flutter, they burn up too many calories.
Agree or disagree, Tita? He says it takes place early in his life.
I disagree.
Neutering. As soon as they can find it.
The neutering takes place early in the capon's life. No, you should have agreed with Terence, and Christine gets
I'm
that one.
You, listen to me.
But the bell means the time is up. $875. She was way ahead. Congratulations, Tito Molde. Well done. That was good sportsmanship. Now, of course, she just left, but she's gone over to join Gene Rayburn, gets set for a shot at $30,000, potentially. Ah, Christine. Yeah, she really kind of pulled ahead and stayed there and was very consistent all through the day. But with the $125 you won today, you've won $800 altogether. Congratulations. You're a good sport, and you pulled your way through your laryngitis. Christine Ledinsky, Gene Rayburn.
Okay, John, here we are with the champ. She's our new champ, and we'll be back with her and our nine stars for a go at the big money right after this. Thank you, Johnny O. Here we are. Ready, Tita?
Very ready.
She says she's very ready. You know, you could win up to $30,000 here in the Super Match. We wish you very well. Let's begin. We polled a studio audience not too long ago, and we said, please write down your best answer to this. Blank rag. If you give us the answer they wrote down most often, you get $1,000 for the second, $500, and $250 for the third. Whom do you call on? Any three.
Kim.
Wash. Rag.
Wash rag is one.
Ed.
Old rag.
Old rag. That's Sorry. The best you can do, right, Ed?
It's pathetic, isn't it?
Right.
This is my day. Thursdays are bad for me.
Yeah. Terence is trying to get your attention.
Glad rag.
Glad rag.
Glad
you
rag.
Never heard of that?
Yeah. Just, I had a better one.
Just for your information, when you say, I'm going to put on my glad rags because I got a big date tonight, means you're going to put on your best-looking clothes.
Yeah, come on.
Or when you're a child, it would mean your Sunday clothes. Remember, you had an everyday outfit and a Sunday outfit? Well, that's what glad rag means, just in case you didn't understand it. So there you have those three. You have two so far. No, you have three, don't you? You have wash rag, old rag, and glad rag. Patty, wash, old, and glad. Okay? All right. Now, you choose one of those or give us one of your own.
Wash rags.
Ed. Wash rag.
Ed.
All right, we're going to find out if it's up there. And if so, where? Audience, you seem to agree with her, and we'll find out right now, okay? Let's take a look at the $250 response. Dust rag is up there. We hadn't heard that. Let's see what the $500 one says. Dish rag is there for $500.
Come on, wash.
And the $1,000 response says...
I told you!
Terence gave it to you. And you take rejection very well, don't you, Terence? Anyway.
Well, I listen. Had dish.
What's that? You had it.
Dish.
All right. Listen, you didn't win any money up there, but since you are the current champ, we're going to stake you to $100 so that you can play the head-to-head match with any star of your choosing here. And after you've made your decision and chosen one of the stars, that person will reveal a hidden number, and we'll multiply the $100 by whatever number is revealed. And since you only have $100 to start with, now it's more important than ever, I suppose, to see if you can get that big 3-0. Look them over and just think who might have the 30 and see if you can choose that person.
Eric.
Eric? All right, would you grab the tab and reveal it? It's 20. So you are playing for $2,000. $2,000. Not bad. $2,000. Ready? Here we go, Eric. Whoops. blank space, S-P-A-C-E. All right, he made up his mind very quickly, and you collect the $2,000 simply by matching him. What do you say, Tita?
Outer space.
Says outer space. All right, Eric, she says outer will get the $2,000.
I'm so sorry, Tita. That was my first response was outer. And then I went to, and then I changed it to outer.
Well, you've done well here. You've got $2,975. Congratulations to you. We'll be back with Tita and the Stars in a moment. First this. Here we go now. Now we will find out which of the Stars had the big number. Shall we? All together now. One, oh. Two, three, reveal. Norman. Had it.
Norman, is it you?
Is that you? No, is that you, Norman? Yeah, that's you. Well, listen, St. Elsewhere Bunch, you are splendid again as usual. We'll look forward to seeing you tomorrow.
Glad.
And you will be back tomorrow, Tita. Gene Rayburn here inviting you to join us tomorrow.
And John Bowman saying so long for the Match Game Hollywood Squares Hour. See you tomorrow.
A member of our studio audience will receive this KitchenAid mixer with a passions. It can handle almost every task from a single leg right to kneading each dose. A complete food prepare furnished by KitchenAid. And this is Johnny Olson speaking for the Match Game Hollywood Squares Hour, a Mark Goodson television production.